Meet the new executive director of the Bronx Council on the Arts.
Every time I say it, I laugh, I just smile.
Following a six-month search for a new executive director, the Bronx Council on the Arts held a reception to welcome Viviana Bianchi as their new leader to guide the organization that since 1962 has served a pivotal role in developing and guiding Bronx artists.
It represents an opportunity, scary at the same time challenging, a moment of opportunity and a moment where I can put my vision and the vision of my team to work.
And it couldn't have come at a better time with BCA scheduled to open their new headquarters in Westchester Square in 2018, with a career dedicated to nurturing her creative arts community in both Argentina, where she was born and raised, and here in the U.S. while living in Miami, Washington, D.C., and here in the Bronx, where she worked at Mind Builders Creative Arts Center. Bianchi looks forward to building on that in this new role.
All my life also I worked in the social sector, so this kind of represents the two paths coming together and being able to do a lot of things with what I know and what I love.
For me, this is a powerful and wonderful moment for BCA as we are poised to open a building, as we're looking at different ways that we can continue to build infrastructure here for artists.
We have a strong and vibrant arts community in the Bronx, and this robust community includes individuals, arts organizations, performing arts venues, and BronxNet has been there partnering with organizations, great organizations like the Bronx Council on the Arts for over 25 years.
Partnering with Bianchi, BronxNet Television's executive director Michael Maxnaby, who spearheaded the expansion of his studios to the Westchester Square community, where BCA will soon be a part of.
She's terrific, she's engaged, she's familiar with the landscape working at Mind Builders, and we are excited to partner with the Bronx Council on the Arts under the leadership of great people like Viviana Bianchi.
Others, they're pleased with Bianchi's vision and the renewed focus on the arts. Executive Director of the Bronx Tourism Council, Olga Luz Tirado.
We're already talking about how to collaborate and get more tourism into the Bronx and appreciating the wonderful work that's being done here.
What I'm happy to see is how artists are very resourceful, how they make a lot with bare materials or with an idea, with a concept, with their identity. They're not hiding that, they're putting that up front.
And Juanita Alonzo, curator and director here at the Longwood Gallery at Hostos, where currently Bolero is on exhibit through December, called it a great day for all artists looking to grow their careers. Linda Cunningham, executive director of Bronx Art Space, a gallery located in the Mott Haven section, share the same.
This is extremely important to help and support the Bronx community and the artists that are giving back to that community. And as the Bronx grows.
Along with tonight's exhibit, you can get a full listing of upcoming events sponsored by the Bronx Council on the Arts by going to bronxarts.org. For BronxNet, this is Arlene McCoco.